Welcome to A Career in Review, where every year on the first day of the fourth month, we take a look at an actor whose long and varied career we'd be foolish to ignore.
This year's honoree has already opened two new movies since January, and if IMDb is correct, this 47-year-old will have five more that open up throughout the rest of the year, bringing his total to over 60.
So now, we present our official statement on the career thus far of Nicolas Coppola Cage.
Nicolas Cage, what the fuck?
Since he first started appearing in films in the 1980s, we've been met with the moody, hysterical Nick Cage of Raising Arizona, the moody, romantic Nick Cage of Moonstruck, and then came the moody, drunken Nick Cage of Leaving Las Vegas, which begat the moody Nicolas Cage twins of Adaptation, and now we're kind of left with a moody shell of a Nick Cage with National Treasure, G-Force, National Treasure 2, next, The Wicker Man, and the highly anticipated and soon to come out, but still in development, National Treasure 3. Nicolas Cage, what's going to be your legacy?
You have an Oscar for Leaving Las Vegas. You have Lifetime and Decade Achievement Awards from critics worldwide. You're on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. You've even done films we would watch again and again, like Wild at Heart and The Weatherman. We'd rather not see you coast through life waiting for another award-winning role and in the meantime pick a bunch of freaky films. I mean, I understand tax problems can make anyone go a little crazy, but did you think no one would notice Season of the Witch, Bangkok, Dangerous, or Knowing? Are those films supposed to show us that you matured past Trapped in Paradise? Mel Gibson has a comeback working with a puppet. A beaver puppet! A beaver puppet! Meanwhile, you're busting your ass to get a part in Astro Boy. What's wrong with this picture?
I mean, we love you. But when someone on YouTube can make a 4-minute video comprised of all the moments in a movie where you've lost your shit, that person may be laughing at you. I mean, they realize that the madman shtick repeated over and over again may not be a weighty acting career, but self-parody. So we ask you, where is the wistful and charming Nick Cage from Honeymoon in Vegas, or the shady Nick Cage from Matchstick Men, or the spiritual Nick Cage from Bringing Out the Dead, or the punky new wave Nick Cage from Valley Girl? Alright, that's a little dated, but you get my point about range, right?
Wait a minute. He's been building up to this with every character that he's played. The dude in Face Off, the guy who ate the cockroaches, the twin brothers, the Ghost Rider. He wants his audience to go crazy just like him!
Crazy, but that's how it goes. Millions of people living this world. Mental wounds not healing. Life's a fantasy. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
Come on, we're just yanking your chain, Nick Cage.
Yeah, thanks for being a good sport.
But seriously.
Truly. What the fuck?
Nicolas Cage, what the fuck?
Nicolas.
Nicolas.